What?
Tomorrow when you're giving your stuff,
yeah,
be on her side.
That'll work.
And some, look, they got to do one more thing to make sure you got the skirt going down.
Yeah. Okay.
So we'll be
what?
Done. The when you step up the right.
You really
no, you don't step up. See, boom, catch him. He's
that,
run.
The offensive part of that.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So bring it right up. Right up here, then shifting up.
If you're throwing a left hook.
Yeah. Show me again. Right foot comes out.
Watch. All right, in two of our forms, work on angling. The 38 and the short punch, those two forms. At the end, you notice you got a left hook, straight right hand, you slide right, come back right hand, left hook, close the door with a cut kick. First tactic that I'll teach you in a good boxing gym is after you step up with a 1-2 punch, 1-2, they'll teach you slide right, back with a counter right hand. Everybody get it? That's just cold-blooded, simple amateur boxing, especially if you're a tall guy. You've got to learn what I'm showing you. The best tactic in the world. Little guy's pressuring you, see? Step back, right hand, slide right, goose him again. Now watch me when I slide. Phil, let me use you for a second here. Come here, face me. Just looks better on camera. See, they go, damn, look how big Joe Lewis is, you know? I thought he's only 6 foot, but damn. And this guy bench presses 450 pounds, so he really makes me look good. Huh? 425? What's the difference? All right. Now watch. When you fire the right hand, if you step straight out to your right, so you're out of range. Is everybody see it? So you slide right, my rear foot's at 6 o'clock. I don't step straight across. I cut in. So I end up behind his heel if I can stay on the clock. Is everybody got it? It's called a slide step. Straight punch, you're going to create an angle. His position is weak. I mean, hold on. If I throw a right hand, he's going to roll his shoulder. Roll. Now for me, he's going to ride my punch back in with a counter right hand. See it? Boom. No, back to the chin. Roll. Boom. Right back. Boom. I get hit. So at the end of my right hand, as I start to pull it back, you all understand riding, okay? You don't follow punches back in. You ride them. So right now, as I'm starting to pull my hand back, as I'm recovering, my position's weak. What happens when my position weak? I get hit. So as soon as I finish the punch, as I start my recovery, as this punch is coming back in, I slide. He goes over my shoulder. Now notice, my position is now strong again. He's wide open not only for a kick, an uppercut, but a straight right hand. Does everybody see it? So tall guys, watch what we're doing. Watch the drill. He starts to step in. As he starts to step in, I step back, freeze frame. Open your mitt up so I don't hit you. Open your right mitt. You throw a straight right hand. Don't leave it out there, please. Recover. As you recover, he's going to throw an open palm jab right at your head. You slide over. You can turn with me, and I can throw a counter right hand, back left hook. Now watch Phil do it, all right, as I'm coming at Phil. So as I step in Phil, he jabs and takes a little half step back, throws my range off. See, I can't reach him. So right now his position is strong, my position is weak. What does he do? He fires, straight right hand, boom. But now, see, now he's weak because I come back with a counter right hand. So I come back with a counter right hand, what does he do? He slides over. Woo! He rides it back, right hand, left hook, boom, cut, boom, boom, good. Now I say he's creating an angles. This is what we're going to get into tomorrow, learning how to create angles. But now I'm showing you how to put the finishing touches on a tall guy with a little guy putting pressure on you.